Yeah, definitely. McKenzie had done a lot for me. We'd been with him for a long time, and I think I signed with Mick after 3 fights. So, you know, we've been there for a long time, and you know, he took me over to America and managed to box on some big bills over there. And you know, yeah, he did a lot for me. But you know, the way the boxing climate was, Mick was struggling with TV dates and stuff, and you know, it didn't make sense for me to stay there. Now I think my prime years are coming now, and I need to be in the big fights now if I'm gonna do anything in boxing. And Mick was struggling, so you know, then I went to Frank Warren then, and you know, if anyone's going to deliver, it's Frank Warren. He's tried and tested, he's been there, he's done it before with other boxers, and you know, he can take me out of them leisure centres now and put me in them big arenas, which is where I want to be, fighting for world titles. It's my first one on the Warren. Tricky opponent. I've watched him, I've seen a clip of him on YouTube, and it looks like he can whack a bit with his left hook and stuff, and yeah, tricky opponent. I mean, we don't really know much about him, but these can be the banana skins, you know. It's a fight I'm sure I'm supposed to win, and I'm supposed to look good winning, but you know, I've got to make sure I go out there and do a number on him, and there's no room for error in this fight, so there's, you know, the pressure's on me to perform, and I'm training hard, and I'm looking to go out there and put on a really good show. The lightweight division at the moment, it's wide open. I think all the world champions out there are beatable, I think, and you know, I put myself in there with any of them, and that's what I'm looking for. I need to get this fight out of the way first and get myself back up and running, because it's been quite a long break since my last fight, while I've been sorting out, you know, leaving Mick and signing with Frank and stuff. That's took longer than Danny hoped, and yeah, I just want to get this one out of the way, get this opponent out of the way, and then I'm looking at having a real big fight, and hopefully for a world title, yeah. I'm not sure yet. Like I say, we haven't got any opponents lined up, we're just getting this next fight out of the way, and hopefully I'm going to get a world title shot. I mean, I think I deserve it. I've won a Lonsdale bout outright, won a European defender at once, this will be the second defence now, and then hopefully I'll go on and get a world title shot. I mean, if you have to fight Karim along the way to get the shot, then so be it, but I'll fight anyone, that's the way I am. I mean, if that's what he thinks, that's what he thinks, but I know in the back of his mind he's just been knocked out of Katsidis, and although he beat Prescott, I think, you know, was a bit overrated anyway because of the calm performance, I think, flattered him. I mean, Mitchell, I think, a little bit above his station. I think he thinks he's better than what he is. I mean, if he wants to fight, I'll fight him. Got no problem with that, and I'm sure I'll knock him out. I've proved myself, like I say, I'm the best lightweight in the country. I've got all the world rankings above Kevin. Well, Kevin definitely needs me more than I need him, but like I say, it's an interesting fight for everyone out there, and I mean, if I have to go through Kevin to get my world title shot, then so be it. That's the way I am. I mean, I boxed everyone who I've had to, everyone who they put in front of me. You know, the Faxton fight was an interesting fight, and a lot of people thought I was going to lose that, and the way I dealt with him, I think, showed my class, and as well, if you have to go through Kevin and show my class again, I will. I mean, I've always done things the hard way. I've never been given or offered easy fights or anything like that. So, I mean, I'll fight anyone, and that's just the way I am. And like I say, Kevin, if he gets in the way, he's going to get mullered like the rest of him off. And that's it. That's it. Driving me forward, I think still after all this time, I'm still a very, very hungry fighter. I mean, a lot of fighters that would get to my stage, you know, 30 fights undefeated, they've had money and stuff by now, but I haven't really. I mean, and it's kept me very hungry and very humble, and I'm still working hard in the gym. I'm still doing everything I can to better myself, and I'm working on technique, and when these fights come, it's not a challenge for me to get up and get out of bed and go running. You know, I'm still very hungry, and I get up and I do my runs, and I'm working around the gym. I've got a lot of young, hungry fighters coming up behind me now. Anthony Crawler, my brother Joseph, Smith brothers are in our gym, Matthew Macklin, and you know, he's a great spirit in the gym at the minute, and everyone's pushing everybody else on, and you know, it keeps you dedicated. Bam Bam Rios, I'm sure we've been down there fighting a couple of times, or it's been potential for the fight to come off with us. He's a come forward fighter, very aggressive, similar to myself, and I'm sure if me and him have a fight, it'd be a toe-to-toe war, and you know, everyone in Britain would love it, and the American TV would love it. It'd be a great fight, and for as long as it lasted, and I'm sure it's a fight I'll come out on top on as well. Julio Cesar Chavez, one of my heroes, and you know, I watched him in against Meldrick Taylor when he stopped him in 12, and he was losing the fight on points, and it shows you with boxing, you can win at any time, and as long as you know, keep your head on, keep your pressure on, you can get him out of there. Yeah, definitely. I've said that to Joe in the past in training camps, you know, 15 rounds would definitely have suited me. You know, more time to get in there, more time to break them down, but you know, it's a hard game, and I understand why it's 12 rounds. Yeah, I mean, I'd love to fight Marquez. I mean, he's an absolute legend in the game, and share a ring with him, you know, would be a great honour and a great privilege. I think he's definitely the best out of all the lightweight champions, and I'd love to fight him. I mean, if I want to be a world champion, I want to fight the best to prove that I'm the best, and that's the way I've always been. I mean, Joe Gallagher's a very good trainer, and he knows how to get the best out of people, and you know, he's certainly got the best out of me over the nearly 8 years career what I've had as a pro, and he's starting to get the results with other fighters now, and you know, having all such good fighters in the gym, and that, you know, if you're on the bag or if you're doing something, you look up, you can see other fighters around you working hard, and if you're looking to have a breather, then you can just take a look around, and no one else is cutting corners, no one else is cheating, so, you know, it helps inspire you to get on your job and get your work done, and, you know, success breeds success, they say, and it certainly has in this gym, and, you know, we've had a lot of success up to now, to this point, but I'm sure, you know, there's going to be a lot more success to come. Yeah, but that's it. Yeah, it was referred to as the capital when you know, we had Ricky Gomez, Farnell, Rhodey, them type of fighters about, and you know, they've all retired now, and you know, the next generation's coming through, and it's still very strong with myself, Matthew Martin, you know, Anthony Crawler, Craig Watson, all these lot coming through, and you know, it's just showing how strong in depth the fighters are in Manchester, and the trainers as well, you know, got to give a lot of credit to them, that they keep producing, taking kids like myself from off street corners and in the gym, and working as hard and drilling us into the ground and producing champions. Yeah, it's been a part of my life since I was about 3 years old, when my dad, obviously me and my brothers, my middle brother Stephen and his dad Joey, there's only 2 years between the three of us, and obviously growing up the Rocky films was big and that, and we used to have us with the post office boxing gloves we used to buy, and we used to have little boxing matches in the back room and that, from being like 3-4 years old, so you know, that it's been part of my life for a long time, and you know, since going down to the gym about 11 years old, you know, I've come a long way, and I've loved it ever since I've started, and you know, Joseph's the same, and Stephen, although he don't box, it's part of his life as well, obviously, with us two doing it, and you know, he did a lot of training himself, although he don't box, you know, it's a part of the family, and it has been for a long time. Pride, determination, I want to prove myself to be the best, and you know, like I said, it is a very hard game, it's a tough sport, but there's times when you have lows and there's times when you have highs, and you know, just sticking with it. And I've worked very hard for this now for a long time. From my first amateur fight, I think I was about 15 when he had it, and I'm nearly 27 now, so it's a good 12-year career nearly. And I've you know, there's not a day but I've come to the gym when I've cut corners, and I've always dedicated myself to it and trained real hard in the gym, and I think it shows in the fights just how dedicated I am, and the way I grind people down and that. So you know, I've put a lot of work into it to get to this point where I am now, but I'm sure there's although I've climbed a mountain to get where I am, I'm sure the next challenge for me is just a bigger mountain to get to again. So you know, I'm working hard, and the success of winning world titles and the pride and prestigious awards what comes with it, you know, that's what drives me on. And like I say, I'm looking forward to hopefully challenging for the world titles this year. We're away in London now, as all my mates are saying, we're London away. So yeah, everyone's looking forward to it, and I'm going to take my army down to London, and we'll have a right ball, yeah. A lot of pressure fighters I like, and a lot of fighters that are in great wars, you know, these Barrera, Morales, them type of fighters. I love also Ouazghari, just the heart that they show in fights, and although they get knocked down, they'll get back up again, and they'll keep coming at you. And you know, that's what I try and base myself on. You know, sometimes in fights when I've been caught with shots, and you know, been hurt, but you know, I'm just not show out and keep that stony look on my face, and keep like coming forward, drilling into him, and eventually I'll get him. And you know, that fighters like that inspire me, because I've seen them go through some tough fights, and there's times when they could have quite easily swallowed it, but then obviously they wouldn't have been the greats what they are. And you know, that's the same as me. I'm just going to keep coming and keep coming. And there's a film out now with Mickey Ward, the fighter, and you know, I watched that film and I loved it, and I loved it that much. I've watched it four times now, but he's another fighter, you know. He took his knocks, he got beat a few times, but he got back up, and he came back, and eventually got that title shot that he wanted, and he won it. And you know, it takes a lot of pride and a lot of dedication to do that, and that's what I try and do for myself as well. Maybe it'd be a lot crazier than that Mickey Ward film, I'm telling you. Joey. Joey's my favourite fighter, yeah. And I'm Joey's favourite fighter. That's what we say. Nah, there's a lot of talent in our gym, to be honest. Andy Crollo, I do a lot of sparring with him, and I really rate him. I think out there now, I put him in there with any lightweight in the country, and I'm sure he could pull it off. And you know, like I say, the British boxing as a whole is on a high at the minute. There seems to be a lot of fighters there or thereabouts knocking on world titles. On the door for world titles, and you know, I think British boxing in general is coming through a bit of a purple patch, and hopefully we can bring a few world titles on this year for us. Definitely. I mean, I work with Anthony a lot in the gym, and I've seen him grow as a fighter and come on over the last 12, 18 months, and. You know, he's such a dedicated kid and such a nice lad. You know, he deserved his title shot, and he'd come through some tough fights with Andy Morris and Michael Brody, and I think he wanted his shot. He really deserved it, and for him to get a chance at 2 weeks' notice at the weight division above and pull it off the way he did, you know, it's just superb, and I was over the moon for him. I'm hoping for a world title shot this year. Hopefully win that world title, get Manchester rocking again. I mean, I'm sure Frank could take me to the MEN Arena if I win that world title, and I'm sure we could have done great nights of boxing, what we used to have with Ricky Hatton. And you know, eventually, obviously, the pinnacle is to go over to Vegas and have fights, and in huge world title fights. And you know, that's the dream, and just keep following it, yeah. That's what keeps me hungry, that's what drives me on. There's a lot of work to be done, and like I said, just keep working, keep dedicated, and who knows where the journey can end. So, yeah, I'm sure, you know, stay dedicated, stay true to myself, and if I'm good enough, then why not?